Hi, I'm Dr. Johnny, and I'm talking about 5 tips to dissolve facial filler, what to watch for, what to do, and what not to do. Dissolving filler, we started in 2003 with hyaluronic acid fillers. Restylane was the first one, and we really didn't know much about dissolving it then. It's evolved to today, where in a fairly busy practice, you're going to be using these dissolvents at least on a weekly basis for one of many reasons. Most commonly, fine-tuning and adjusting filler or starting over, getting rid of existing filler to have a new canvas to work on. But the beauty is we can dissolve filler. There's Hyalinex, which is recombinant DNA. That's what I use. And then there's also other ones. And in the past, we didn't have the recombinant, but the ovine-based ones are still used in many clinics. You can skin test or not, depending on your protocols. There's other ones around the world, but I find the recombinant DNA technology is very predictable, and I like those. The standard of care today, I would say, is over 600 units on stock in a clinic at any one time. Watch for the expiration date. These things need to be kept cool, to be active. They do last a long time, but typically expiration dates are out about a year or so. So check your stock if you don't use it regularly. But most clinics now, I want to say it's normal if you're dissolving filler. It's just part of what we do. Patients have had fillers now since 2003. They can move forward through the tissues. Maybe they don't like the angle. Maybe there's too much. Maybe there's little irregularities or lumps or bumps. It does not get rid of your natural collagen, and we'll talk about that. Number one, it's not specific to the point that where you place it. It's a dispersant. So if someone wants minutia treated, you can put a small amount in and it either won't get rid of it or it will do a good job. But you really can't tell between that and a small dose. As you use a bigger dose, because it's a dispersant by nature, you might get rid of too much. So when you're doing this, of course, if you have an emergent situation, you just get rid of it, I'll use a high dose. But if you're fine tuning, you have to tell the patient that we might need to add a little bit after, or we might need to redo it again, depending on your dosing. So it's really a non-specific, non-pointed treatment in a global sense. So test it and let your patient know so the expectations are set. Number two, don't use it too early in the treatment. What we're seeing now, especially with Instagram, people thinking these treatments are instant, and I talk all the time about it taking 2 weeks to settle in. People want to come and get it taken out maybe a day when they're seeing swelling or two after the treatment. Don't treat too early or dissolve too early. Make the patient wait a couple weeks to settle in. I'm not talking about a bad side effect. I'm just talking about if they don't fully like the angle, think there's too much, think it's too high or too big. If you dissolve it early, you get rid of some product, but some of the product, it changes its characteristic nature, and the product can float to the surface. The product can move in places you don't want it, and you might end up having to dissolve the whole thing when, if you did nothing, it would have settled in perfectly. Number three, it stings. It can sting some people. So when you put it in, there is a little bit of pain involved, especially with Hyalinex. And if you want to anesthetize the area, you can, but you don't want to put enough fluid in to lose your landmarks. I typically don't use any anesthetic, but I warn the patient you can use vibratory anesthetic, but it can sting a little bit and be sensitive to that. Number four is the storage of it. It needs to be kept cool, and about 600 units is what you need. The most common thing I see when I walk in, people say, oh yeah, we have it, and you look, and it's from 4 years ago. While it actually does last a long time in an emergent situation, I think that's worth using. I think in general, you have to keep it within the expiration time and keep it cool. The storage is key. If you freeze it by mistake, it's done. It loses all its effectiveness. Number five, and we learned this early on, we really thought this was going to be a problem, was it does not get rid of your natural collagen long term. We did think that, however, and we know now that if you get rid of the filler, it really targets hyaluronic acid. If it does get rid of some of your own collagen, that's reproduced over 72 hours. So there's no long-term effect. When you do use it and you get rid of product, what you will find, the skin will have wrinkles and there can be an unusual divot for a few days, but that always settles in unless the product was holding that area up and creating a look they actually wanted. So it won't get rid of their own collagen. It's safe to use. Just give it a week or so to fully settle in and the skin will look a little wrinkled. You might have to handhold the patient through a few days of that. They can emolliate it, use some hydrating creams, won't affect it. It works fairly quickly. You can see a result within hours. Sometimes it takes a couple days to see the full effect, but it can dissolve within minutes, the filler itself. It's just that the skin takes a little while to contract and get back to normal status. So there's 5 tips on dissolving filler. Most importantly, know that it's normal in 2019 to be using hyaluronidase on a regular basis to fine tune and take care of our patients. We're looking at smaller angles, smaller folds. Patients have been injected for a while. The filler does move forward in the tissues. There's lymphatic drainage around the eyes. All those reasons, the eye's gonna be the number one area where you're gonna have to dissolve a filler in your practice. So let us know what you do below in the comments. Subscribe to this channel on YouTube here for continued helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.